Welcome back to BreslovCampus, insights in the parsha of the week, Parshat Vayeitzei. We see that the Torah makes a big deal about Yaakov Avinu pushing off sleep. It says in the beginning of the parsha that he slept, right? Vayishkav b'makom ahu. He slept in that place when he was running away from Esav towards Aram to go to Lavan in order to find his marriage partners, Rachel and Leah, eventually. But the Torah says that he slept that night, and that's when he had the dream with the ladder, etc. But Rashi points out that he slept only that night, but he did not sleep for the next 14 years when hiding and learning Torah by the Torah study halls of Shem and Ever. Right? It says that he was up, pushing up sleep, learning day and night. And then later on, when eventually he came to Lavan and started working for Lavan, and he had to work, right, 7 years for Leah, and then 7 years for Rachel, right? And then there's additional years that he was there. So when, afterwards, at the end of the parsha, when Lavan comes running after him, and Yaakov's arguing with him, what do you want from me? Why are you bothering me like this? I worked so hard for you, I was so dedicated, right? And he says, I pushed off the sleep again, day and night, I was guarding the sheep. Even at nighttime, he said, Yaakov Avinu. So we see that Yaakov Avinu is a lot associated with pushing off sleep. Rebbe Nachman talks about this idea in Lesson 35, how there is Torah at what's called an awakened level, and there's Torah which is in sleep mode. He calls the Pshat of the Torah, which is basically the oral Torah, the Torah Shebaal Peh, which is the Gemara, the Talmud, and the developed halachas, that's called sleep mode Torah, because as opposed to learning, if you want to say Kabbalah and the secrets of the Torah, which deal with direct divine connection in ideas, the Torah of Pshat, of the Gemara, the Talmud, is dealing with the intellectual dialectics of the derivatives of Hashem's will. You're not necessarily focusing on Hashem directly, but in the subconscious, Hashem is there, and we're learning things like the laws of Kashrut, the laws of Shabbat. So I'm now involved in the details. If the light is like this, if now turning on Shabbat, if I'm able to turn on a timer like this, you're now involved in the details of the laws. So it's called because of that sleep mode Torah, as opposed to open awareness about topics which dealing directly about Hashem, that's called awakened mode. And Yaakov, not sleeping, he symbolizes that level, that higher level of the Torah. But he connected to Rachel and Leah. Rachel, Rabbi Nachman teaches, Rav Nosson explains this, she corresponds to the oral Torah, because the oral Torah, the Gemara said, is compared to a sheep. Just like every part of the sheep is useful, you can use the hair, you can use the skin, you can use the nails, you can use the veins, use the meat, every part of the animal, of the horns, everything, every part of the animal can be used. So too, there's many, many sections of the oral Torah, every part can be used. That's how Rachel, which is translated as a Rachel, a sheep, okay? Leah also corresponds to the oral Torah, she's the idea of prayer. Like it says, and the eyes of Leah were rakot, soft, because she was always crying, so she didn't look presentable because her eyes were always like stained with tears, so they became very pink and red, and it ruined her beauty in a sense. But both, compared to Yaakov, are called sleep mode devotions, because Yaakov was awake. That was the whole thing of Yaakov not sleeping for 14 years by Shem and Ever, and also in guarding the sheep, he also maintained sleep mode, being pushed away from sleep mode and staying awake. But he had to join two Rachel and Leah.